might actually go to jail. And Lucy was picking out a reading material. Fortunately, the Florida Supreme Court overturned that conviction in 1976 and established a limited protection for reporter sources that actually still exists today. 1982, she was a Pulitzer finalist for her investigation of drug trafficking in Dixie and Taylor counties, which I happen to drive through today. And that's resulted
with the times
I did not tell
them.
I didn't tell them that. I did not slow down. And that resulted in more than 250 people going to jail, including some government officials. But years later, there was another young reporter who was covering a hurricane in that area, and a guy approached him and looked at the St. Petersburg Times press box, press pass, and said, "Do you know Lucy Morgan?" And the reporter said, "Well, yeah, she's my boss." And the guy said, "Well, when you get back to Tallahassee, you do me a favor, and you give the old bitch a kick in the crotch, but she put me in jail." In 1985, Lucy actually did win the Pulitzer Prize for investigative reporting with fellow Times reporter Jack Reed for a series of stories dealing with all sorts of corruption in the Pasco Sheriff's Office. And a year later, she came up here to be the Capitol Bureau Chief for the St. Petersburg Times. And a year after that, she asked me if I wanted to come up, and I worked for her for a few years. Before I fled and then came back. There are all sorts of stories about her ability to get probably thousands of public records from the state. And of course, her legendary as an equal opportunity questioner. But over 20 years, she covered four governors, two Democrats, and two Republicans. And this is how much the state changed in the 20 years she ran the Bureau. In 1986, her first session, there were a total of 76 Democrats and 44 Republicans in the legislature. In her last session, there were 84 Republicans and 36 Democrats. So she did quite a thing. One time when I was doing another one of these introductions, I rounded up some quotes from Lucy over her Tallahassee years. Here's three of my favorites. She was talking to a government spokesman in 2001, and she got exasperated. She finally said, "If you can think up a good quote to defend why the agency is attacking cripples, you let me know." She was questioning Democratic candidate for Governor Bill McBride when she asked, "Do you remember introducing a friend by discussing how big his male appendage was?" So probably one of my favorites is after hanging up with the secretary of a North Florida sheriff, following a conversation in which Lucy's drawl became steadily more pronounced as she tried to get some cooperation, she slammed down the phone and said, "Don't try to out-southern me, honey." So the Florida Senate Press Gallery, of course, is named after Lucy, and she was inducted into the Florida Women's Hall of Fame as well. But here's my favorite quote from Lucy that she gave to a biographer one time about her favorite story. And she said, "Well, there was one favorite story, and it didn't win any prizes, but that didn't matter." She says, "There was a sheriff in North Florida County who was requiring the female inmates to give him oral sex if they wanted to be a trustee or for any special favor. He seemed to think he couldn't get AIDS if it was just oral sex. All these women had records. No one would believe them. A judge sentenced one woman to go back to jail, and she started crying and asked if she could tell him something in private. She told him what the sheriff was doing, and he believed her. He called the Florida Department of Law Enforcement, and they investigated it. The prosecutor assigned to it didn't think he could take the sheriff to court over it, so some officers I knew called me. And I went over there, and I interviewed the judge and some of the women, and we did a big series on it. And after it ran, the feds got interested. 22 women testified before a federal grand jury, and he was convicted, and he was sent to prison. And the day after he was sent to prison, when I got to work, there were a dozen roses sitting on my desk. And the card read, 'From the women you believed.'" And those women didn't have any money. Lucy's been my friend, my surrogate grandmother to my kids, a mentor, my role model for more than 30 years. We don't have any roses tonight. I probably forgot those. But
I hope you haven't changed.
She doesn't have her knit needles tonight. She has a bunch of knit needles. Because one of them is liable to go like that. But I hope this award in her name inspires and honors another generation or two of journalists who appreciate the value of public records and maybe learn a thing or two from her example, just like I did. So thanks.